About a couple of years ago, I was lucky to be able to get a custom studio desk made for me, and I changed a few things since that time, and I want to talk about it in this video. Hi, I'm Velanche. I am a DJ and founder of local DJ collective Soul Dust Productions. I'm also an aspiring music producer and a music enthusiast, so if you want to be able to follow my musical journey, you can be able to go ahead and click on the subscribe button below. So a couple of years ago, I have gotten a really nice custom-made studio desk. It's been great to have. I have enjoyed using it. But over time, I changed a few things on that studio desk. This video is an update to the original video that I posted about a couple of years ago when I first got that studio desk. I changed a few things around, and so let's go ahead and talk about that right now. This is a studio desk that was custom made for me about a couple of years ago by a couple of really cool guys, Ryan and Chad, at a local custom furniture making company called Appendix and Bow. And I have been in love with this desk. I really dig the custom design. As far as I know, I'm probably the only one to have this. I'm not sure if anyone else has got it, but if you want to be able to check them out, to be able to try to get something like this, link will be in the video description. So let's start with the middle of my studio desk. This is probably the biggest major change that I've done. I've had the monitor there the whole time, but not this setup here, which is taking up the middle of my desk. And I'll start here with the Launchpad Pro Mark III. Apple had announced support for the Launchpad series of MIDI controllers for Novation around 10.5 when they introduce live loops and these other loops here. And with the 10.6 update, it introduced more robust support for the Launchpad Pro. Awesome to have all this in a compact size as opposed to having a full keyboard and a really versatile MIDI controller. And then over here, I have the Maschine Jam that I purchased back in 2015, 2016. It's been a while. And this is a controller for the Maschine software for native instruments, but it's also a generic MIDI controller. And I am using this currently with Logic to use as a control surface. These would be the faders going up and down. And I made solo mute here. And if you see one of the buttons lit here, that's the selected track. There are banks of eight at a time. I could be able to go down to another bank if I wanted to. I do automation and also other things with this. I can zoom in and zoom out. That's part of the 1-2 punch that I got, so I can be able to have maximum control when I use Logic or another DAW. Down here is the Magic Keyboard from Apple. Not to be confused with the Magic Keyboard for the iPads. The reason why you're seeing this in black here is because it is a custom keyboard cover that I've got. You can see the original here. This is a large print keyboard made by a company called KB Covers, and it's a pretty awesome keyboard cover with large print, and there are various times of various kinds of large print ones that you can be able to get. Over here is the Apple Magic Trackpad. I've been using trackpads at home since about 2011, 2012 with the Apple computer that I've gotten. And this, it way better for me using trackpads as opposed to using a mouse. So let's go up here a little bit. This is monitor that I have for, I guess, almost 3 years, 4 years now. This is the LG 34-inch widescreen monitor, and it is, I think it's IPS. It's not 4K, but my vision is such that I don't really need the 4K. This is bright enough for me. It's crisp enough for me, especially when I zoom in and out with my accessibility tools built into the operating system. It works great. On the top, Logitech C930E. I think that is the name of the webcam. I've had that since 2019, so long before the world shut down. It's a HD webcam, not 4K, but it is widescreen, and it is a really solid work kit. And it is on top of something that I've gotten last year from a company called BenQ. Is B-E-N-Q. This is called the Studio Bar, a screen bar. That's the name of it. It is a lamp, an LED lamp that has multiple settings to be able to control the brightness, several settings to control the type of lighting that you want, either natural lighting or fluorescent type lighting. And you can be able to choose those either manually, or if you want to, you can be able to have the light automatically adjust to the ambience of the room. This is so great because it's able to illuminate down on this stuff, and it makes it so that I don't have to be able to use extra light. I can just be able to have it focus on this area only. And it's been supremely useful. Okay, so let's go to the left here, and right here is my baby 14-inch M1 Max MacBook Pro. I got that one a year ago, and by far it is the best laptop I have ever owned. It is encased in a Tech 21 laptop case that I've gotten with that, and it is standing on a vertical stand that I bought I want to say about 2018, 2019, I bought this. Next to that is a Thunderbolt 3 dock from a company called Plugable. And this is really the hub of the system next to the MacBook Pro here, because I have just about everything that has to do with needing any power plug into here. I have everything from my audio interface to the monitor to the USB hub that has a whole bunch of USB-A connectors on it. The beautiful thing about having this device is that I can be able to just plug in one cable that goes into the back of the laptop, or rather go to one the side of the laptop. And then I just take one cable, unplug it,
slip the laptop in my bag, plug it back in when I'm ready to use it again, and then boom, everything comes to life. And yeah, I've never had anything like that before. I had things that are close to it, but yeah, nothing like this, and everything works. And you know, just one in and one out. It's just super, super convenient. Next to it, another pluggable product is a power strip with a whole bunch of things plug in there. There's also a couple of USB-A ports. One of them charges up my watch, and I use this mostly to charge things. And I think I have another item that's actually plug in. Let's go over here. This is the LP120 turntable by Audio Technica, and I use this mainly to listen to the records I have over here. I have a bunch of other records too, but I originally got it to sample music from, and I might still be able to sample some music from there at some point, but otherwise I was able to find room on the studio desk to be able to play records when I want to, and there it is. And we'll take this off. This is the turntable there. And this is a gift that one of my DJ friends had given me for my birthday. John Morales mixing Teddy Pendergrass, the teddy bear. And then this is one of the recent devices. This is actually the device that is plugged into that USB port on the power strip. And I got this not too long ago because my site isn't all that great. I needed to be able to have something with not only good lighting, but also different strengths of light, so I can be able to see really close to where I need it. And this is good for the turntable, but it's also good for the item that's down below here. This is an area where I plan to be able to learn to use some of the live gear. And the live gear that I have currently plugged in right now is the TR-8 from Roland. This came out in 2014. I bought it back in 2016, I think. 2016 I ended up buying it. But I lent it to one of my friends for a few years, and I got this back, I want to say a year or so ago. But now I'm now just starting to learn how to use this drum machine, which is hybrid Roland's classic 808 and 909 drum machines. But there's an expansion that I purchased, which also has additional Roland drum machines, the 707, the 727, the 606, and additional drum sounds. So, yep. Give you a little demonstration here. So we'll go to pattern. Okay, that is the TR-8, and then behind it is another Roland product. This is the TB-3, which is Roland's touch version of the TB-303 bass instrument, and that's been known for getting the classic acid house sounds from back in the day. It's not plugged in now because that is going to be the next instrument I learn once I get a handle on the TR-8. So I'm going to turn this off now. And then this is another Roland instrument. I recently got this. In fact, I got this about a year ago too. This is the SP404 Mark II. This is the sampler and effects unit. A big upgrade to the one that Roland had released some years ago, the original SP404. I haven't had time to be able to get that deep into the weeds, but I have done some chopping and cut up a couple of classic 70s tunes with it, and it's fun to play with. It'll be even more fun for me to be able to integrate this with the rest of the gear that I got. This is the Heil PR40 microphone. I actually bought this microphone back in 2013, a long time ago. And I have used it before to be able to do podcasts at home of my radio show, but I haven't gone without it. Stored away for a while, and now I put it back into service to be able to use it once again for live streaming and also for new podcasts on my show, among other things. It's also on a Heil boom with the Heil shock mount. Yeah, so that is the Heil PR40 broadcast microphone. And then covering my cap here, have a pair of headphones from Beyerdynamic. I have two versions of the DT770 headphones, recommended to me long time ago by an engineer up in the UK. And I have the 32 ohm version, and that is good if you have a mobile device that you want to be able to plug into, or a laptop. That's definitely what it was made for. It was first made as a limited edition, and now shouldn't be too hard to get. But the one with the velvet cup that I have is the 80 ohm version, and I got this one to be able to work better as a reference headphone with my audio interface. It is the Apollo Twin, and that is made by the folks at Universal Audio. I've been using it mostly as an audio interface. I have not used the Unison software that it comes with, but I have plugged in not just my computer, but also I have the turntable and the TR-8 plug into a splitter, and that splitter is plugged into the back of the audio interface here. And I also have this microphone jack that sticks out because I plan to have a microphone plug into there as well. All right, here is my iPad Pro. M1 iPad Pro. I got this back in the summer of 21. Also, the Magic Keyboard. I got this 11-inch version after three versions of the 12.9-inch version of the iPad Pro. I like the smaller size because the bigger size is getting kind of unwieldy, kind of big. But I have it, and it is a great size to have. Really versatile, really portable, and yeah, I use it a lot, whether I am out and about or at home. I think finally, open up the tray here that has a couple of contents in it. This is the Korg Nano Control Studio. I had it in a case. I pulled out a case recently and decided to put this here to use as a mini control surface, particularly this big knob here for automation. This is the control, complete control S49 Mark II for native instrument. And it's been a good keyboard. I have a number of instruments, many virtual instruments that I can be able to use with the complete control NKS standard, where you can be able to preview sounds before you load them. So it's there when I need something like that. So that's good to have. And finally, I guess let's just talk about the speakers that I got. This is the Tapco S8. Speakers that I gotten back in 2006-2007. I've held on to them, obviously. I don't need to get rid of them. It's not the best sounding speakers in, compared with, say, Yamaha or Foco, but they're really good enough for me, especially in a place like this. And this is the other one over here. And then underneath, this is the Tapco S10, which is the subwoofer that goes along with the whole thing. And all this sounds really decent, especially for a home setup. And yeah, that is my home setup as far as a home studio setup. And all of the contents taking up my studio desk.
I hope you enjoyed that video on my studio desk and the rearranging that I've done on it. So thanks for joining me. I'm excited to be able to share more content here regarding things related to DJing and music production and other music related stuff. I am excited to share these things with you. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to click the like button. If you want to be able to stay on this journey, please go ahead and subscribe to the channel. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll be back with you with a brand new video. Take care of yourselves. All right, peace.